everybody, welcome back to another episode of Last Day on Earth Survival Day Return. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, you guys are an absolute favorite guest today. I'm doing so awesome because right now we got some absolutely crazy info we gotta share. The first piece of info is just kind of like a heads up, but the second piece, yo, there's some big moves being made. So without further ado, Kafir posted this just earlier today on their Twitter. Good morning, slash afternoon, slash night, slash evening, slash everything, I guess. Survivors, we hope all of you had a wonderful weekend. Just to make things clear, the news above is not a joke. Make sure to transfer your loot from the bunker. Raiders are coming. If you guys don't know what they're referencing the tweet right below that tweet saying, Survivors, Raiders are planning a global raid on the Alpha Bunker. We advise you to transfer loot from there to a safe place as soon as possible. P.S. It is not a Fool's Day joke. So I don't get why they just announced that today, because everyone thought it was an April Fool's Day joke. But thank you to Kafir for clarifying, because now people know, all right, it's legit. So Raiders are going to be coming for the bunker. We are actually going to be evacuating, hopefully, some of our supplies today. We also do have some tickets, so might as well do a couple of unboxings over in the bunker as well. But this is crazy, a global raid coming for that. But we're going to go ahead and talk about that potentially a little bit later here in a sec, because if anything, I think that just points to signs that the lobby of the bunker might very well be changing, or something about the bunker is going to be changing where potentially our loot is going to, like, you know, not be there anymore. But here is the big ticket item. This was not even announced. This was shouts out to Salazar7217 over on Twitter for tweeting this out at me at Starsnipe. At the end of the first part of the teaser, I saw that thing in the corner. Could it be a new coupon system or something similar? At first I'm like, oh dude, it's just a conspiracy theory, no one. But then I looked into it, I'm like, hold up, wait a minute, that something's not right. That actually looks incredibly like the ticket system, and right here you guys will be seeing me getting a little bit more of a high definition shot. His video, or his screenshot, was just a little bit blurry, so here you guys are going to be seeing a little bit more in depth. And if you guys do look in that upper left hand corner, that looks exactly like how the ticket system looks, or like the conveyor belt at least looks, over in Bunker Alpha. Now I'd love to hear what you guys got to say about this in the comment section down below, and by the comments, which are their way, it's a $25 iTunes/Play Store gift card giveaway. Gotta do as well as make sure to like button, make sure you subscribe, and that will answer you in on today's video. Feel free to enter on every single Last Day on Earth video. Saturday rolls around, we pick a random video from the past week, pick a random comment from a random video, because that's the winner, and we kick off a new weekly giveaway as well. So make sure that notification bell set so you don't miss anything. But my thoughts on this are one of two things. Either A, there's going to be some sort of new ticket system over here in Sector 7, kind of similar to the Bunker Alpha ticket system, where we will be able to go redeem some of these tickets potentially. It'll probably be a different currency, I feel like. Maybe Bunker Alpha will have tickets in Sector 7 / the Infected Zone. There will be something else. Or another thing that I was thinking about, especially when we saw the radioactive suits and these special type of backpacks that the radioactive suits did have to have, and I'm guessing we're going to need the radioactive suits as was revealed in this kind of teaser. We're going to be needing them to access the Infected Zone due to the radioactive materials. So what that has me thinking, what if that conveyor belt, when you're into the Infected Zone, if you want to extract any loot from the Infected Zone, something similar, game mechanics like this have been implemented in whatchamacallit, this one game, if you guys ever played Division, Tom Clancy's Division, that came out a year or two ago. Actually, the second Division looks pretty cool. Might hop into that when that time comes. But there was a dark zone, and in the dark zone, you had to extract your materials because they were infected. So what if in Sector 7, in the Infected Zone, there is a better loot? It is highly rumored, highly speculated, and honestly, lots of evidence that this might very well be our first taste of a multiplayer zone as well. So what if to extract stuff from the multiplayer zone, you have to put it through some sort of conveyor belt system? You know, you can't just walk out, you can't just log out or something like that. You have to transport it to this conveyor belt, and then the conveyor belt will safely bring it back to the normal area, because this is separating two sides. You know, this is a giant wall, kind of like in the Division, kind of how there was, like, you know, the Infected Zone on one half of a wall pretty much, and then normal zone on the other side that wasn't as infected, that wasn't as dark, so to speak. So I think that there's actually a lot of evidence that something's gonna be going on, at least with the conveyor belt. We can't see like a ticket or a crate coming out of there, so we can't confirm that it is gonna be a ticket system, but I think those are the two most likely things. Either a new ticket system using some sort of currency specific to Sector 7 and the wall, or it is going to be something more along the lines of, like, you have to extract your loot through a conveyor belt or something like that. But that is an absolutely ridiculous catch. Yo, Salazar7217, shouts out to you. Thank you so much. And since he did tweet at me, hey, if you guys aren't following me yet, at StarSnipe1, I tweet funny things sometimes, right? Nah, my Instagram's better. Just posted a pretty funny Instagram today, actually. And I might be doing some gift card giveaways on the Instagram as well, at StarSnipe. So, just give me a little bit of a heads up right there. But with that said, like I said, I'd love to hear what you guys got to say about that. And then I think that's about all that I got to say about the ticket system. But the Raiders, too, that is saying a good amount. I think it means something big is going to change. You know, like they wouldn't just get rid of our stuff in Bunker Alpha because they would have done it by now. You know, they already have plenty of opportunities, too. There's got to be a reason for this to happen. They're just giving an in-game reason. So with all of that said, with all of that done, let's go ahead and let's begin bunker evacuation protocol, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. But dude, yo, Salazar, that is a ridiculously amazing catch. Thank you so much for spotting that. That is wicked and honestly has me even more hype because at first I didn't think that was it. I'm like, dude, it's probably just a box. But then I looked at it, I'm like, that is legitimately exactly like the conveyor belt in the bunker. We'll even be heading over to the bunker. We'll be using the conveyor belt so you guys can get a little bit of a comparison when we do go there firsthand. But for us to head over there firsthand, there are a couple of things that we need to do and a little something that I noticed that I want to give you guys a heads up on and potentially get your thoughts on as well, because we have yet to be revenge raided again, right? So much so, actually, that we've dropped down a skull, which is weird. That means we really haven't been revenge raider in a while. And I think the reason for this, I wanted to bring this up because I want to see if you guys have ever experienced this, but I think it's because I never repaired these two chests that have been raided. At first, like, that was the only thing that's kind of, you know, like, it kind of makes sense. You know, it really does. So I'd love to hear from you guys in the comment section down below if per snaps you've ever witnessed something like this. If maybe you've ever, I don't know, you know, it just, it might be a coincidence, but it's suspicious for us not to be raided that long. And the one difference, the one key difference is usually I repair these things right away. This one time I just kind of like forgot to repair them. It's been like 2-3 days. We haven't been revenge raided. That's weird, dude. That is really weird. And because of that weirdness, we do need to set out and do a normal raid today. And it sucks because we probably missed out on our revenge raid, because maybe that's why the skull dropped down. Maybe we were supposed to be revenge raided, but because of the fact that we didn't repair these chests, the revenge raid didn't go through for some reason, but our skull level dropped. Because usually skull levels don't drop unless you get like raided, you know? I don't know, but I'd love to hear from you guys if maybe you've noticed anything with that, or maybe you know anything about that, because I just have my suspicions there, you know? Little suspicions. But let's head on over and let's do two things. Number one, let's find the Raiders wherever they might be. Where are you, Raiders? There you are, marvelous. We'll be saying hello to them very shortly. And of course, the bunker code for today to hopefully help you guys out. If this bunker code is expired by the time you guys are watching this video, hopefully someone in the comment section down below, that fan-freaking-tastic, helpful community known as us, hopefully someone dropped it down. Because usually, dude, every comment section, I'm always seeing you guys doing that, which is awesome. So hopefully someone dropped down a updated bunker code. Today's is a 419982. That is what you are going to need to succeed in today's bunker runs. We do have enough red tickets as well for a whatchamacallit to actually open stuff up. But given the fact that we have seen that conveyor belt over in the Sector 7 zone, and I maybe this new update, they're changing something that's making Bunker Alpha, like, they're gonna loot it, you know? It has me suspicious here that I just want to save onto the red tickets. They might be useful once the time comes. So here we can see the things that we do have to knock out. If we are lucky, I don't think we can get a C4, actually, unfortunately. And they do want us to go back and down to the fourth floor, though. I'm not gonna refuse you there, guy. I'm just gonna go ahead and start heading on over so we can begin the evacuation process, because we might still have some valuables over on that top floor. I think I took out most of them, but again, it is time for us to start evacuating the bunker. And dude, I'm just so excited for that conveyor belt. Like, I can't believe I didn't notice that. That's just such a great catch. That was so low-key in the corner too. And dude, that honestly alludes to a lot of things, and it answers absolutely no questions, just brings up more, same as it brought up my hype level. Then again, what doesn't bring up my hype level, dude? I could go to the bathroom, you know, be sitting on the toilet, that my hype level would probably go up, you know, just like, yeah, I'm so excited to finish going to the bathroom, you know. Wouldn't surprise me. Would not surprise. But I hope you guys that it was your favorite Gutastic day again of only the most favorite Gutastic variety. I'm doing pretty good, dude. I stayed up pretty late at night. I was grinding out some computer science homework for collage. That was a wee bit of a struggle. But the auto grader is getting graded today. So hopefully all's Gucci McSwaggins with that. Then I just gotta do some homework and stuff and hopefully get some more videos coming your guys' way. Because as much as I would love to totally not do school at all, I am doing school at all. So, yeah, can't just ditch everything and do YouTube videos and streams as much as I would freaking love to that. And I'm pretty sure if I recorded or streamed even more, my neighbors would get back to the noise complaint life. Dude, it's I don't want to jinx it. And I don't want the neighbors to hear because maybe the other neighbors don't know that they can file noise complaints. But we've been good for like a couple of weeks here, so hopefully it stays that way. That'd be really nice, because I've been slowly getting louder and louder too. Except for the weekends where I've been home. Like, I was home this past weekend and recorded some videos, because Easter. I was the Easter Bunny. No, I wasn't. I hid some Easter eggs though for my godson. It was adorable. The end. Saw my girlfriend too. Gave her a nice old hug. Posted a picture on Instagram with her. In case anyone's curious, at StarStipe. Shameless plug, la 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 la. No, I kid. There's a little bit of shame. So what's up? We're gonna need to try and get some water in our hands. Let's take out the fast bite. Oh no, our dog didn't come with. Aw, man. That's alright. He deserves a little bit of a break. I'm not doing anything too nutty, too crazy. But for real, look at the structure of that thing. I'm just saying, that looks a lot like what we saw in the trailer with the conveyor belt. Especially the big thing that looks like it is this stuff on the top. Like, the way that the actual belt itself kind of lays. I don't know, dude. Maybe I'm just falling into the conspiracy, but I feel pretty confident about it, you know? I got a good feeling that... Ow! Let's freaking go, baby! I'll go ahead. Two engine parts, a little bit of shotgun ray, a little bit of the pistola. That is marvelous, marvelous, marvelous news. Oh, just makes me a happy campery-do. And we don't even need to swap anything out, because we got some full-quality armor over here. We are about to die of thirst, but that's okay, dude. We got two more engine parts to add to the stockpile. Bless the frick up, boys. That is awesome. Let's go ahead and get that pistol for ourselves as well. Let's keep on eating some baked beans here to tide over a hunger. And we should have a little bottle of the Wheater. The Wheater, are you in the inbox, Wheater? Ah, there is the Wheater. I like the Wheater. It keeps me hydrated and good to go. There we go. Back up to 100 hydration and 98 fullness. And we're looking pretty Gucci McSwaggins here. Yo, Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi, what is you doing, baby? I got a good Wi-Fi. Don't go complaining like that. If we take a quick peek here, we are really, really close to finishing up the specialist. So maybe when 1.8 drops for sure, I'll try and get these last couple of things. Maybe we'll get some of these items during our raid. But maybe the floppy disks will start dropping new stuff as well. Would not surprise me if they did add in something like that. So I do want to be a little bit preparado for such a circumstance. And we don't have anything else chilling in there. We don't have anything there. We're really close to that floppy disk. Maybe if we're lucky, we find more floppy disks too. I don't know, but so with that said, with that done, I would say we are looking pretty good over here on this front. Now let's go back up to the lobby and to evacuate absolutely everything that we can that's at least valuable, you know. Like, I got some pretty random stuff here that if I lose it, it's not the worst thing in the world. If we do fill up our inventory, I'll come back here, make sure to grab it before it is too late, and then Then we'll start heading on over to the Raiders, talk to them. Speed racer. Go through them quests of theirs and go on a little bit of a raid for ourselves, lads. Nothing super crazy there. Like, you guys can see, we don't really have anything ridiculously amazing, all things considered. There's some okay stuff, don't get me wrong. Like, honestly, might take some of that our own home a little bit. A little bit of leftover shotgun rain. Never hurt nobody. And ooh, definitely some of these that actually have quality left on them. I have like a chest full of gas masks back at home. Like, I'm not too worried about. I got a good amount of fur armor back at home too. And so I'd say I'm pretty happy with what we got, all things considered. Maybe I'll grab one gas mask right there, and we will call it at that as we evacuate the bunker. And dude, after that Sector 7 comes out, I just feel like we're gonna be spending way more time there than Bunker Alpha 2. Hopefully Sector 7 has some chest topside that we can like store stuff in, just because it's really easy. It's really nifty. Like, I moved my stuff when I think update 1.7 came out. That or one of the follow-ups to 1.7. And like, they said that it was possible for raiders to raid the bunkers and stuff. You know, I evacuated all the good stuff out of there, but ooh, we had a couple of places that might be worth visiting. I just want to get a raid in. That airdrop's lasting for a while. Raid's probably going to be right around here. We might be able to save some energy and just go there right after the raid. Worst case, fill up on some fuel. We'll be Gucci McSwaggins. Now then, hopefully the raiders are Gucci McSwaggins and give us a nice place to raid. That would be ideal. Watch, if we come home and we've been revenge raided. Actually, dude, I'd be pretty hype about that. Low key, that'd be pretty freaking cool. Not gonna lie. In a weird way, but it would be. Don't get me wrong. Because that free raid, because we haven't done the Raiders quest yet, and it'd be nice. Although, if we did get raided, we still have to do a Raiders raid regardless, because we are only at 3 skulls, and we want to be at 4 skulls. So that's why we really got to try and knock this out today. So, my Raider brethren, let's go ahead, knock some of these puppies out. I do have some hatchets chilling in my inbox that I'll actually go ahead and grab, but I also need to go ahead and put a ton of this stuff away, especially those engine parts, dude. 2 engine parts is freaking awesome. I love opening green and yellow ticket crates. Like, they're so much easier to open. I have so many green tickets. I got a solid amount of yellows. And, dude, they still give you a good amount of stuff. Like, all things considered, is pretty freaking dope. But with that said, with that done, I'm organizing the inventory a little bit. Get the proper guns, and we're going to go on our way. Ooh, up to 70 over here. That is looking very nice. All right, back on topic. BRB. And we are looking marvelous right about now, ladies and gentlemen, with the VSS over here with the solid amount of durability left, a full quality, fully modded AK, 5 hatchets, and probably some baked beans that I'm gonna go ahead and we'll chow down on them first things first. Just eat a couple, make sure we're Gucci there, then we'll toss them into the old pickup truck, which is going to be vulnerable to raids, which is why we never leave stuff there anymore. And let's talk to these dudes. Let's complete the raid and let's begin the long trek. Well, it's not really a trek, it's more of a drive. And let's fill up on some gas, so we got that popping for us. Let's begin that little drive over there and let's start making our way over to where this guy is. Please, boys and girls, start crossing those fingers and sitting in that crisscross applesauce position with maybe a cross eye or two, because this is it, baby. Will we get a good raid? I sure as hell freaking hope so, because I would be so down for putting in some work on this sucker, right here. B6AIY30's base. That's a very sketchy name. Just a bunch of random letters and numbers, I think. Usually, those are the sketchiest, but in a good way, where per schnapps, there will be good things. Ooh, we are heading here with only 2 C4, though. Hopefully, that doesn't come back to bite us in the bum. The one time I don't bring 3 C4 after getting burned badly on that one raid, dude. Oh, if I get burned again, I am not gonna be a happy camper. Oh, I'm gonna be a freaking salty camper. Let me just say. But still, this is going to be a good raid regardless. Even if we don't get the best stuff, at least it'll bring our danger level back up to 4 skulls. And we just got to make sure, if my hypothesis is correct, to repair the chests as soon as possible, because I think leaving destroyed chests does not allow you to raid. And ooh la la, we have a big base and some stone. Oh my, that is a lot of stone. Oh me, oh my. Oh. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Well, he has a lot of spikes around here. Yeah, dude, of course. The one time we could have really used it. What do? I don't bring the right stuff. Is this stone? Oh, dude, oh my God. This man has stone everywhere. I hope it's just stone, like caking, you know, like one layer of stone, not like multiple layers. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to try and break into the level 2 zone right here. I know it's probably risque,
right? But yeah, you never know. Maybe it'll be okay. I kind of want to break through the doorway and see where this goes, but this might be a little bit of a doozy. Oh, this is going to be a tough raid. Oh, I wish I brought that third C4. That would come in handy. Nah, it looks like we do need to head this way. Well, here's what we're going to do. I'm not going to put it where the doorways are. If I'm going to blow into stuff, we're blowing in through random walls. Although, I don't know if I want to break through that wall. Ow. Why did that just hurt so much? I don't know if I want to break through that wall specifically. I kind of want to break through one of the walls by a ton of those spikes. You know what I'm talking about? Kind of like over here. I feel like this is where the goodies are going to be. Why don't we break through one of these and see where it takes us? You know what I mean? Actually, right around here especially. You guys see that? He's got extra layers there. Why don't we break through two of these spike traps? Shouldn't use that. Can you start chopping there, big guy? There you go. Ow. Talk about pain. But we should be able to break through it. Doesn't make a crazy amount of noise. Makes a little bit. Not a crazy amount, though. And then why don't we break through You know what? Let's just set this charge up right here. Let's book it as soon as that thing's set. And big boom. Boom. Big boom, and one chest was opened up, but I think that means that enemies are... Yeah, there they are. They're going to start flooding in. Luckily... Oh, dude, they're going to be taking massive damage from all these spikes. Oh, this is actually really handy. This is going to make our jobs even easier. Oh, my. I like what I see. And we do still have one C4 left to go through, and it looks like we got through a pretty... Dude, bless up that we didn't go through the doorway. Freaking called it. We were just going to be bamboozled so hard if that happened. But all right. We have one chest here that we already broke into with just a bajillion wood. Okay. Nothing too crazy there. We could try and use a C4 to break into here. Honestly, I am pretty tempted to do this. I really do want to do this. I don't want to do it where the doorway is, though. I wonder if I could plant it over on this wall. Get kind of a couple of things blown up there. Ooh! Yes, we can. We're up to 71 noise, though. Jesus, man. That's not good. Hopefully, these dudes run into some spikes and make our lives easier, because we're not going to be able to break through everything, which is a little bit unfortunate. All right, let's deal with you here. We're only going to be able to break, like... Oh, my God. That dude's arm went flying. I don't know how many chests we're going to be able to break into here. Maybe we shouldn't have broken into that. We do have two broken chests here that maybe... Yeah, nothing crazy. We got some things, and we got the broken chest on. Oh yeah, this side's not good. I don't like the loot on this side. I don't trust the loot on this side. I think that I am going to trust maybe the colored chests. Those are always like a solid bet. What about here? He doesn't have any electronic circuits invested. All right, definitely interested in the red chest. Just maybe he's coloring his best chest, you know? You never know. He could be. Nope, it's just a random chest, as is tradition at this point, pretty much. And we do have some of these dudes running through. Oh, boy. Hopefully they hurt themselves a little bit here on the way. They're not hurting themselves as much, though. Let's be ready to swap on over to that. They finish them off with the AKs. We do got the rest of the abominations coming our way. And, just notice this. A box of the military variety. We still have like three more chests we can open, so disappointment. Wow. Where could this guy's best stuff be? It's got to be one of these random chests. I don't know which. There's just too many chests to go through. Maybe it's this room. Honestly, looking at... he does have spikes over there. And then there is like two layers of walls on the other side. I just don't know, dude. This is going to be tough. We might try and finesse the big one in this type of raid. We definitely got the axes to do it. We got the axes to actually do quite a little bit here. And we do have the first aid kits as well. This is going to be a busy day. Wish me luck, boys. We're going in deep. If we could just hit the jackpot on one of these chests, though, I'd be freaking stoked. So let's go ahead and we'll break through one of these, and then we'll start softening up the rest. Dude, he just has a bajillion satellite dishes. We got three hatchets left. We'll break until we're at 99 noise, or until we have one hatchet left. I think that's a good strategy. Good way of doing this, possible. So here's the thing. I'm not seeing this guy's welcome mat, like his welcome home mat. I feel like that might be in the best part of his base. It's not here. Maybe he doesn't have one? I don't know. Before we do anything too ballsy, let's check that pickup truck, see if maybe he's got an offering for us. You know, kind of gonna keep us happy. Dear God, I love these spikes. They're helping me more than they're helping his base, honestly. Does he have an offering? Just one of those things. Alrighty there, Tiger. I'll go ahead and do that. Don't have a lot of noise to play with, though. This is getting no bueno. No bueno, no bueno. Alright, which one did we soften up? Did we already soften one up, or did we... No, we're gonna start the softening process now. Okie dokie, artichoke. I kinda wanna check out a couple of these. I feel like there's hope. Let's get two chops on a couple of these over here. Honestly, I kinda wanna just break into these. You know, he does have a lot of layers on that side protecting it. Just such a hard decision. Maybe these three, because they're on, like, wooden floors, you know? Maybe that's how he marks his best chests. He just puts them on wooden floors. So we got those three. That's how we're going to remember. We got three on the wooden floors softened up. And then I want to try and find a couple in here to soften up too. So one and two. We'll do these two. Hopefully we can remember these two. And our hatch is going to break here. We might be able to soften up one more before the time comes. Let's go with... we got those two. And oh, colored chest that I totally missed. Okay. 100% we're breaking into these. Hopefully the big one isn't summoned too fast. We gotta be ready to kite. Things are about to get loco. Begin the process. He's coming. Okay, nothing good there. What do we got here? Oh, he is not a happy camper. Got hit through there. That's not good. Oh, hopefully these toxic abominations get hurt on the spikes too. I don't think the big one can die on the spikes, unfortunately. That would have made our lives so much easier, but I do think he does start regenerating after a little while, which is rather unfortunate for us. Don't hurt me, big one. What have I done to you? I haven't killed you in a long time. Just let me be. Let me be. He's pretty hot on our tail, though, but at least we got some good separation between us and the abominations, which is going to be really good. Hopefully get stuck on something. That'd be nice. And let's break through these really quickly. There we go. I'm doing the chopping now. We'll come back and harvest them in a little bit. I think that's actually a good way of doing this too. That should be a lot quicker than trying to grab them all at once too. You know what I mean? Okay. There we go. He's getting some hits off on us. Let's get some separation from that. I think all the abominations have died, which is good news. Let's start that owl. The separation track over here. Hopefully he gets caught on some stuff while he's turning some corners. We still got a solid amount of stuff here to fandangle with, which is good. He is catching up, though. He's definitely faster than we are. Oh, I should have put some stuff into the motorcycle before we started this. Ow! Thank you for the hit there, big one. Alright, and then here comes a little bit of a moment of truth. God, I wish he would just die on these things. That'd be so freaking handy, man. Alright, what do we got here? We got nada importante. Anything in there? No, that's the satellites we already opened up. Alright, that leaves us with three chests here. They're probably just gonna be a little bit, just... Oh, let's go, baby! Let's go! The Hail Mary paid off! And we still have a hatchet we could chop some stuff down with, but guys, we found a good chest. Let's go! I saw at least 7 copper in that thing. Oh, mama. And we still got 13 first aid kits. I think we'll be good on that front. Maybe if we're lucky, maybe it glitches out and the big one manages to die. That would be amazing. I don't think it's happening. I don't believe it's happening, but you never know. You know, gotta have hope sometimes. All right, get your hit. Smack me a little bit there. Smack me around, big one. I know you want to here. Oh, there we go. Let's heal up. Oh, let's get back to that chest. I'm just gonna hit the take all button, dude. We just gotta grab everything that we can from this, because this has... Valuables. Yes, sir. Very nice. Okay, and I kind of want to break the one that's next to it, too. I feel like this one could have some good stuff. There we go. All right, let's try to get some separation from him really quickly. Do the wall trick. Oh, that is a little trick you can do. Okay. Oh, no. Okay, there we go. I totally messed up that trick. Doesn't matter. I just want to see if there's anything good. Let's go! Miniguns, heals. Dude. We came up clutch in the last seconds. I still think that there's probably better stuff here. And also, just to show you guys, because I do get this question sometimes. You're like, Star, why don't you try and kill the big one? You know, like, you can kill the big one. He's killable. Just to show you guys, I think right around 200 health, he will start regenerating. Or he'll just instantly regenerate to 1,000. So I just want to show this to you guys so you know I'm not trying to bamboozle you. And also because it does take a while to do this. We still got 8 medkits, but we picked up hella more medkits. So as long as our armor stays good, we can stick around a little bit, boys and girls. Definitely. Definitely. Ow. Okay, got a hit off on us there. Let's go. Did we already collect everything from here? We got all the valuables from there. Let's see what's ever in this one. There we go. Let's heal up really quickly. What do we got? Just tons of carrots. You're a carrot type of man. I didn't think you'd be a carrot type of man, but hey, you do you there, broski. I think those are the best things, though, so just make sure, A, not to get cornered, and B, get some separation between us and the big one, and let's get back to breaking some of these chests, at least until this hatchet is donezo. We should at least have, oh, well, that's the last one, and I don't think there's anything that valuable there, but really quickly, I'm gonna grab that meat, because I could go with some of that. Okay, there we go, let's make sure that we don't die, and let's get the hell out of Dodge with a last second buzzer beater type of raid. That raid, actually, dude, how close is the big one? Let's just kite him around a little bit. I really do want to show you guys this little trick that I'm talking about here. You guys can see he's down to 250. He should be really close to the point where he's not going to be a very happy camper with us, you know? Okay, there we go. He should start running along. Oh, let's make sure that we don't die on accident either. There we go. Let's let him hit us here, because then he stops moving, and then he should walk through. Yep, look at that right there. Back to 1,000 he goes. You are not going to stop the big one if he is chasing you around, but that doesn't matter. Let's take some time here. Let's actually look at our inventory, because I was not paying attention at all. I just saw there was copper. I saw there was steel. I saw there was a minigun. I saw absolutely no specifics, though. So let's see what the numbers are. I think there was like 7 copper bars. That would be dope, but dude, we're walking out of here with a pretty solid haul, if I do say so myself. Yeah, what is that? That is 9 steel, pretty much, once you take the copper ore into account, 10 steel worth of a raid, which is half of a level 4 wall right there. And honestly, with the amount of steel we have, here's the thing. I'm not going to use the steel. Maybe I'll expand the base a little bit when update 1.8 comes out. But first things first, maybe update 1.8 will require, you know, some steel or some copper for some new items to craft, especially if it is indeed this infected zone, which is honestly, dude, it is looking so hard like it's going to be this zone, and I'm so freaking hyped for it. But we might need some of these items to actually go to work with that. So I am going to be stockpiling these a little bit, but that was a good raid. I wish that I brought the third C4, but actually, on the other hand, if I did bring the third C4, we would probably not have panicked and gotten lucky and broken that last chest, because we would have broken into even more things. Well, if we were doing the big one strategy, though, well, we would have made a lot more noise first. I don't know. Bless up that those toxic abominations died, though, because if it's just the big one wailing on you, if you have full SWAT armor, dude, oh, can you imagine when they have better armor come out, too? Ooh, anything that lets us survive more hits from the big one would be clutch for raids. Especially if that power armor happens. Oh, mama. Oh, mama. Anyways, let's see if we can get lucky and get the doggery do over here from the middle of the crates. No doggery do today. Ay, ay, ay. Ain't that sad? I'm not using my silenced gun on you, homie. I hope it's okay if you die by a minigun. That's awesome, though. That's another minigun. Miniguns, not only are they rare weapons, but they are very valuable and very useful in the construction of turrets. So, all in all, we had a pretty good day. Hold on, we just got a minigun. This guy real quick. So overkill, dude. Minigunning roaming zombies, but we barely use any ammo anyway. Let's see if per schnapps there will be something nice waiting for us in the airdrop. Maybe an engine part? That'd be pretty dope. I don't expect it, but nah, we got a couple of these things, though. But with that, that's gonna wrap it up for this episode of Last Downer Survival. Last second, that raid just buffed out ridiculously, so bless up to that. That copper is gonna be amazing. We're gonna go stockpile it, all that jazz, and I cannot wait to hear what you guys... Oh! Fast biter coming out of nowhere. Cannot wait to hear what you guys gotta say about that ticket/conveyor belt thing that we kinda noticed over in the corner of the teaser trailer for Sector 7/The Wall. And in addition to that, this whole raider thing going on. There's just so much information. I'm just so up for 1.8. I don't know if you guys are as well, but that's gonna go ahead and start wrapping up for me for now. Best of luck to you guys with your Bunker Alpha runs, with the Bunker Alpha tickets, getting the Chopper gas tank and joining the Chopper squadron. Best of luck with your raids. I hope that you end up with some raid loot like I did today. Could have been better, but honestly, still a super dope raid. So best of luck to you guys with that. Best of luck defending your base. Best of luck breeding the puppies, getting that true companion trait, and most importantly of all, best of luck and have an absolutely fan-freaking-tastic time all along the way, and a fan-freaking-tastic day to boot. But that'll do it for me. Thank you guys all the time for watching. Have yourselves an awesome one, and I'll talk to you next one. See ya.